Hi, this is Kong from the www.aegmosfet.com. Today, I'd like to show you how to modify a typical AEG gearbox trigger switch in order to use the burst wizard King Kong MOSFET in the hardwired trigger switch bypass configuration. As shown in the diagram here, right now, a typical trigger switch look exactly like what I show in this diagram. You see the red wire coming in from this outside from the battery cable to one of the contact of the trigger switch, and the other segment of the red wire which goes to the motor. And so I'm going to modify it so that it will look like the trigger switch on the right side. So hang on. Okay, so you can see now I just desolder the red wire from this contact and just move the red wire down to this contact. So now the red wire doesn't go through the trigger switch and directly go to the motor. So the motor basically completely isolated from the trigger switch. So the high current will also be isolated from the trigger switch. So I'm going to do what is shown on this diagram. Then I'm going to resolder a little signal wire, which is a 24 gauge wire, onto the contact which was left open. Okay, I just soldered this signal wire onto the contact that was left open from the original motor wire, and this white wire is this one. It's going to the BW King Kong for the MOSFET control. So with this configuration, the burst wizard King Kong will be used as a hot wire configuration, which protects 100% of your contact switch, and also has the best electrical connection to the motor, so as to enhance the torque or the rate of fire too. Okay. Okay, I have put the gearbox back together. As you can see here, the signal wire is being brought out, and the the motor cable, the wires are being coming out. And then you know that right now the red wire to the motor has totally bypassed the trigger switch. Okay. Okay, so to allow the King Kong to control your AEG, so basically you need to just connect this red wire to the third pad on the front of the board, this one. So I'm going to put solder this wire onto this pad. And that's all you have to do, okay? Okay, I have done that. You see, I soldered the red wire to the third pad on the front of the BW King Kong. Just to be aware that you don't want to short the pads to its adjacent, short the pads together, or the adjacent pads. You may blow the King Kong. So that's the only caution you have to make, okay?